In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
The Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Dear Jesus, we ask you to come now and join us, as you said, two or three that's gathered in your name, you will be with us. Jesus, we ask you to fill our hearts with the desire to please you. Teach us to ask every day, what should I do? May we be a reflection of your joy and love to every person that we encounter today, the fourth Sunday of Advent. Oh, the third Sunday of Advent. Or so let's now hear the word of God.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The crowds asked John the Baptist, "What should we do?" He said to them in reply, "Whoever has two cloaks should share with the person who has none, and whoever has food should do likewise." Even tax collectors came to be baptized, and they said to him, "Teacher, what should we do?" He answered them, "Stop collecting more than what is prescribed." Soldiers also asked him, "And what is that we should do?" He told them, "Do not practice extortion. Do not falsely accuse anyone, and be satisfied with your wages." Now the people were filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, "I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his barn, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." Exhorting them in many other ways, he preached good news to the people. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, today is Gaudete Sunday, third Sunday of Advent. They usually light in rose-colored candle, which means joy. But what is joy, really? Having much money? Maybe, but that's only temporary. Having a good job. There are many ways in experiencing joy, but they don't last. They say that the true joy is to be found in heaven, where we are all predestined. That is our predestination, heaven. We are created for heaven. But how do we attain it? It says, in the season of Advent, conversion. It says conversion. Repentance. Repentance from our many transgressions against God, against our neighbor. it is said that we should confess our sins to clean our hearts. Maybe we do not sin with mortal sins, only small ones, no? But then still they are sins. Maybe however small they are. And it's not so easy. We had to make a sincere act of contrition. And it can be erased. But the consequences of those venial sins are tremendous. The Bible says 1,000 years to a day, and a day to 1,000 years. Can you imagine that? By a human measurement, it's a long time, a long suffering. But we can avoid it by doing our purgatory here on earth. Why wait for purgatory at the last moment? We can do it here, right now, here and now. By offering our sacrifices, pains, sicknesses to God for the conversion of sinners. Because when you offer it for the conversion of sinners, it becomes redemptive. All those trials we encounter every day, they are means of purification. But we don't usually recognize them. In fact, we shy away from these trials. We don't want trials. Who wants them? That's why we are encouraged to be conscious of these small sins. No? Our minds, our consciences. You have to purify them. Naglalaro sa isip natin araw-araw. No? You have to recall those past sins that remain unconfessed. There might be. We need the help of the Holy Spirit to recall them and be convicted of those sins. It says that our purification ought not to start only in purgatory. We are all called to enter into that process of purification here and now. We are called to hear the words of John the Baptist today and repent of all that keeps us from holiness of life. Reflecting on this, upon the purification which God may be calling you, what is it that you hold on to that he wants you to free of? We must commit ourselves to the purifying fire of God's love and let that love cleanse you, cleanse us in this Advent season. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Tito Manny. Tito Elmer, please.
My reflection today will be towards preparing the way of the Lord. So we're now, but today is a special day, a day to rejoice. This is third Sunday of Advent, or what they call Gaudete. Gaudete means rejoice. So it's Gaudete Sunday. Today, we light a pink candle to show the joy in our hearts as the feast of the Nativity draws near, actually nearer. So in this gospel, we can sense the excitement and the anticipation of the crowds, like the soldiers and the tax collector, beseeching John the Baptist for wisdom and direction. They were joyful, wondering if John was the Messiah. And eagerly asking him how to live their lives to please God. So as we start each day, they gave us a good example to follow, asking God, what should I do? Sa Tagalog, Panginoon, anong gagawin ko? The second aspect that I would like to point is that, look, even the tax collectors, the tax collector were very unpopular with the Jews, because they were seen as aiding and abetting the oppressors. They often use their position for overcharging their neighbors and make a profit for themselves. Sa salitang Pinoy, corruption. I'm familiar with that. The Jewish people distrusted these tax collectors and thought of them as sinful and wicked men. Yet, the joyful anticipation and expecting that the Messiah might be near led even those arguably sinful men to ask John, what should I do? How about us? May we never hesitate, no matter how unworthy we feel, to seek God's will for our lives. Love God, serve God. Everything is in that. I have just quoted Saint Clare of Assisi. Let me quote it again. Love God, serve God, and everything is in that. Saint Clare. The third one. It's an easy one. And let me call it simple deeds. Saint Teresa of Calcutta, or if you are in India, Saint Teresa of Kolkata, famously said, if you want to change the world, go home and love your family. Is anybody affected with that? Saint Teresa of Kolkata said, if you want to change the world, go home and love your family. What are we doing wandering around? Go back home. So when John was asked by the people, what are we to do? Tanong nila kay John, anong gagawin namin? And his reply was not really grandiose. But instead it was very simple. He told the seekers to practice simple deeds, to act justly in their profession, and to be satisfied with what they had. Ulitin natin one more time. Saint John simply said to the seekers, the one asking that question, to practice simple deeds, to act justly in their profession, and to be satisfied with what they had. Very nice. Act justly in their profession. No overcharging. Or if somebody cannot pay, then don't ask for payment. And then in your life, just be satisfied with what you have. And that's it. This was an aidless advice from no less than Saint John, for we who seek to live a life pleasing to God. John exemplified this simplicity, simply lang, as he worked to pave the way for the true Messiah. Telling the crowds in all humility, and I quote, one mightier than I is coming. And let me end my prayer. We listen today to his word, exhorting us to share what we have and respect the justice and dignity that everybody deserves. Thus, we shall be preparing ourselves to receive he who is coming to save us and will come again to judge the living and the dead. Lord, I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of your God sandals. As Saint John said in Luke 3, verse 16, And according to St. John, chapter 3, verse 30, he must increase, I must decrease. He must increase and I must decrease. That's from St. John. So let me say, Lord, thank you. Thank you for your words. We would wish to be sitting beside you at this moment, holding you tight. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Tito Elmer. Thank you very much. So today's gospel, no, the message is a repetition of the rest of the gospels, no. It's about sharing, it's about being compassionate, it's about preparation, it's about purification, it's about repentance. And that's also repentance, message of the Advent and message of the Lent. Kaya nga purple ang ano, may purple tayong candles ano, sa yung one of the colors sa candles natin sa Advent is a purple. It's for pink.
Tatlong purple,
isang pink. Oh. Pero yung iba tatlo ang color, may puti, ang iba may white. It's purple,
ang white
pink,
sa gitna
and white. So tapos they wear pink out anong tawag diyan, outfit pala, it only twice
vestment
only twice a year, no, during this Gaudete Sunday and anong Sunday nga yun during the Lent, may isa pa, I think twice lang. But anyway, ang Advent, no, ang Advent is really for repentance and purification of ourselves for the preparation for the coming of Jesus and for the coming of Jesus in our hearts. Tito Manny, no, you mentioned about purgatory. Why wait for purgatory, no, na kung mamatay tayo sa purgatory tayo pupunta because of our venial sins. Why not have purgatory here on earth? So whatever sufferings we have, suffering, sickness and mga discomfort ba, we can offer those discomforts and pains and sickness sa ano, i-offer natin sa kay Lord, kasi nga siya nga inagsuffer ng katakot-takot, tayo pa maganyan ba, so start our purgatory or our purification here on earth while we are still alive. Tapos ang na ko kanina sa one of the masses, no, kanina na narinig ko isang humili ng isang pari isa. Ang sabi ni John the Baptist na share, what are we going to do in order to be purified? Tapos sabi ni John the Baptist, share what you have. So it's still compassion. It's also compassion. So yung isa is stop collecting sa taxpayers. Ang sabi niya, stop collecting more than what is due. So ang message dito siguro is be honest. And be honest. Tapos ang sabi niya sa army, yung army na nagtanong, ang sabi niya sa army is be satisfied with your wages. So ang message dyan siguro is be thankful for what you have. And I don't know kung ilan sa atin dito ang na baptism of the Holy Spirit. Kung naka-attend tayo ng LCS, no, yung seminar natin last year, ng LCS, may baptism of the Holy Spirit. So to strengthen our faith and the Holy Spirit is always with us. The Spirit of God, yun ang purpose ng baptism of the Holy Spirit. So, amen.
Amen. Any other sharing, maybe any comments, any testimony about the goodness of the Lord, about preparation, about purification, about pains, about sufferings, anything gospel related.
The three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, John the Baptist's life was fueled by his burning passion to point others to Jesus and to the coming of his kingdom. Number two, John was preaching to people who were lukewarm about God and complacent in their ways of living. Thus, he tried to urge them to recognize and receive Christ when he came into their midst. Number three, like John the Baptist, we too are called to speak about Jesus' message of eternal salvation and witness its truth effectively and courageously. How do you do this daily? Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Beautiful, Tita Linda. It's true. Mm. It's true.
So I would like to lead the request and lead the prayer for Tito Rolly, who had just, yeah, we know, we understand, and we're not supposed to talk to him about this, that he has a real leukemia. So, Tita Grace, can you lead us with at least three memoraries to praying for the intercession of Mother Mama Mary for Tito Rolly?
Please unmute yourself, Tita Grace. Tita Grace.
Okay. Okay, Najun. Okay.
Okay.
In the name of the Father, the Son, of
the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary,
that never was it known
that anyone needs your protection.
Was left unaided.
Inspired with his confidence,
I fly unto you,
O Virgin, our Mother.
My Mother,
do we come before you? We stand sinful and sorrowful.
O Mother of the Word incarnate,
do not despise our petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer us.
Amen.
Remember,
O most gracious Virgin Mary,
that never was it known
that anyone who fled to your protection
implored your help,
and sought intercession, was left unaided.
Inspired with this confidence,
I fly unto you, O Virgin, my Mother.
To you I come, before you I stand,
sinful and sorrowful.
O Mother, the Word incarnate, do not despise our petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer me. Amen.
Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known
that anyone of your protection
implored your help,
was left unaided.
Inspired with this confidence,
I fly unto thee,
O Virgin, my Mother.
To you we come, before you I stand,
sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate,
do not despise our petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer us. Amen.
In the name of the Father,
of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
For our closing prayer, let us pray the act of contrition for the forgiveness of our sins and for our sincere repentance of our sins. All together, please, the act of contrition. Oh my God,
oh my God, I'm heartily sorry
for having
offended thee.
And I detest all my sins
because
I dread the loss of heaven and the pains of hell. But most of all, because I have offended thee, my God,
who art all good
and deserving of my love,
I firmly resolve
with the help of thy grace to confess my sins, to do penance, and to amend my life.
Amen.
Angel of God,
my guardian dear.
To whom God's love commits me here.
Ever this day, he at my side,
to light and guard,
to rule and guide.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Spirit, amen.
And that ends our prayer meeting for today. And happy Sunday.
Happy Sunday, everyone.
Bye. Thank you very much, Tita Bell. Please come again. Please join us again.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, thank you, everyone. Bye. Thank you again.